we're trying panthers instead of tigers. Maybe that's wrong. We may end up switching to tigers at some point. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Elected to keep the one drops because he's likely a control deck, and this lets us go a little faster. Put on some pressure. Maybe it's better to just put out another one drop there. That annoys me, Black Watch. Oh boy, more random discard. Pass here. Okay, well that will nullify any of those cards that he plays. So let's play, what would we rather lose here? 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, let's play these out. Okay, never mind, I'm gonna have to do this first. Guess we play out the more expensive one. Finish that off. Get with these cards. Oh my god. Can we run into one opponent that's not playing Empire of the Sun or discard? Like, is this what the game has devolved into? It's gross. Like, it's actually gross. Like, I know Empire of the Sun costs 9, but the fact that it's like a get out of jail free card for these decks that just like spew their hands out, it's a bit much. It's a bit much in my opinion. We can't beat a carpet bombing anyway, right? We can't beat a carpet bombing. I'm telling you now, Empire of the Sun's gonna be nerfed at some point. Its cost is probably going to go up by one or two, and it's going to draw you like one or two less cards equal to the power level of the card it destroys. That's my guess. And we're not quite there yet. Guards, guards, guards. Well, we're dead. Maybe there was something different I could have done on that last hand rather than run this out. Yeah, I probably fucked that up that last turn. ambush too, because why not? Ugh, forget it. It's not fun anymore. Let's see what we get. Yeah, I probably could have done something different on that last turn, so we probably could have won that. I'd have to go back and look. Maybe we had enough credits to kill the two guard units and then hit him for lethal there. So fully take responsibility for losing that one rather than getting unlucky at the end there. As much as I'd hate to, I think we have to do this. Yeah. I don't want that to trade with. Hey, Spetsnazer, how you doing? Could be doing better. Getting brutalized by discard decks all morning. Very disheartening. I don't think that's very interesting. It doesn't generate very interesting gameplay to me, and I'm sure it's not very fun to watch on stream either. Yeah, seriously. I mean, we still got that thing in our face, unfortunately. Slow. Maybe I shouldn't have kept so many threes without knowing what these three cards were going to be. I mean, this doesn't do much. Get rid of the free one. Play this since it forces him to run his stuff into that, or use removal, of course. I think we just play on this stuff. That takes a lot of power off the table, so I think I'll do that. Why not? We have the resources. Now it dies to this. Oh shoot. No shoot. There's our gunship mission, finally. Came right on time, too. Fine by me. Opponent put up a fight, that's for sure. Thank you. than that. I think we're doing okay. I don't know if we're ahead quite yet. Yeah, good point. I'll do this, it'll bait out the Leopold again, and then we'll tactical strike it and play out a bunch more stuff. If I was gonna play out the Panzer 38T anyway, I definitely should have drawn first. Play out more stuff, or play out more stuff. Its opponent's opponent is so happy. He got to use his Sky Barons. I'm happy for you too, opponent. What am I doing? I could have killed him. Oh, I still can. That's gonna take a long time, I think. Sorry, guys. Thank you. Okay, sorry about that, guys. Weird phone call. Okay. So, I feel like we can play the Wildcat. He shoots it. That gets it in range for us to naval bombardment. And who knows, if he moves more stuff up on the front line eventually, then we get a little bit more value out of it. But that's fine. I like the cut of our opponent's jib. Well, that's sad. I just trade these off then. Perfect timing. So bad for you. Works for me.
hoping to bait him into doing that and leaving the Jasko alone. Or at least that's why I put those on those side and not on the side with the Jasko. Okay, then. We don't just want to play out two things, yeah? Have we seen the second faction from our opponent yet? I don't think we have. That's another thing I wouldn't mind them changing. When stuff goes back to your hand like that and you're forced to discard, because it's happening all at once, like what? How does the game system determine what gets discarded and what doesn't? I feel like you should be given the choice. Maybe not so much for like when it's coming off the top of your deck, but when a bunch of things enter hand at the same time, it should probably give you the choice of what goes and what stays. I'm actually gonna bounce this, play these out, because if he wants to just keep perpetually get into a bounce war with this, then these are going to come in and... Yeah, but that's like a silly thing to have to keep track of, right? Like, that's just an arbitrary thing that the game decides. Seems like, why not give the players the choice? More player choice. I'm all about player choice. Unfortunately, we're getting a lot of sudden strikes in hand. They seem like they're dead cards in this matchup. Yep. I mean, am I supposed to play around that and just like never win? I think we pretty much have to try to like dodge that. GG's, I guess. No, that was an interesting match. Would be interested in seeing that deck list. Seems interesting. Yeah, last unit played is discarded. That seems wrong to me anyway, because the last unit played is presumably going to be the most valuable one, the one that you'd prefer to keep. So I don't know, is that supposed to be like part of the power of cards like Leopold perhaps? I don't want that to just get bombed, so we'll throw out this. Okay. Okay. I think I'm gonna move this up. I don't want to get strategic bombinged. So I wasn't gonna run out the two wildcats there. I think we gamble. I'd rather not, but what choice do we have? Come on, big money, big money, big money. And now we're gonna get strategic bombinged. Causing 2 damage. If I run out the panther, it dies to this. I guess we have to wait. Pershing, I guess, is the only thing that the US has. That's a good point. The flyer would have protected the panther. I always forget that. I always forget that those cards can do that. Would we be winning anyway? That Pershing is brutal. Definitely didn't put him on Earl Factories. Alright, we'll move on. Playing the panther there wouldn't have done anything. We lose that anyway. Okay, so that's an hour with that deck approximately, so we'll move on to